Hey, it's RadarGreedbagLoquere, and today I'm going to talk about green men. If you've never heard of these before, green men are, they are images of usually their faces, normally depicted as faces, which are either made of or surrounded by foliage. Either they are emerging from foliage, or they are associated, or they're green. The green usually refers to either the color of their skin or, you know, plant life, that they are related to it. It came about because in one of my classes I started doodling. I did something like this, and I was like, hey, kind of looks like a green man, and then it evolved into something more like this, and then it went on, and of course I was taking notes, so like whenever I wasn't in-depth taking notes, I drew another one right there, and this was all today. And then I drew two big ones on the top of the page, a male, and then a femaleish one. I kind of messed up, like, right here, so I was like, but I was thinking about it, mostly because they're actually extremely interesting things, because I'm not sure if there's an exact origin of what they originally were supposed to be, but a lot of people, they usually relate them to, in Wicca, the god, in some cases, as his elder form. You know, they usually have, what, the Oak King and the Holly King? If I'm wrong, I'm pretty sure that's what they are. I haven't really studied that aspect of it thoroughly yet. But I do know that in Egyptian mythology, actually, there is someone who resembles a green man, Osiris, because in some legends, that, you know, the pharaohs, they go into the afterworld, they become one with Osiris, and he is said to have bluish or green skin, which would mean the green man, obviously. It's where you get it from. He's not surrounded by foliage or anything like that. I mean, maybe he is. I don't know. I haven't heard it that way. If you've heard it that way, well, that's cool for you. You know about frilly, foliagey green men. Anyway, Osiris, and what they say about him is, you know, you rejoin him. He's the king of the gods, and so that's how he relates to the green man. But what's really interesting is I actually was reminded of this because I've read about them before, how they take a sort of big position in architecture, those sorts of things. And if you actually look in many early medieval and that sort of era where they were converting all of the pagans to, like, Christianity, Catholicism, that sort of thing. In a lot of the churches, you'll see these images of green men. They actually are their faces. You can Google them and see pictures of them. They're not like obscure things. Everybody's pretty much heard of them. And they are these figures with these faces. They're poking out of the woodwork, that sort of thing. And what it was about is these people who are actually commissioned to do the architecture in the buildings, they used to be pagan, and they were just, you know, evading having to be persecuted against Christianity. So what they did is when they built it, they knew that they were going to be going there to worship the single god. But what they did is they put these images of pagan deities, or just sort of, you know, they're like, they disguise them as part of the architecture. So when they would go to this place, they would be able to pray to these deities, you know, silently, that sort of thing. Because you can use interchangeably, you can say, oh my god, and you can mean the one god, or you could mean, I'm not saying in that specific, but you know, god could be used as the one god, or the pagan god, or any given pagan god. And actually in ancient Greece they would do that. They would say, you do not understand god, and they would say god, but they would mean the entire pantheon of gods that they had. They meant, you know, the concept of god. And anyhow, I was reminded of this because actually if you want to read about them, there's a book review on my page. The Witchcraft from the Inside book. It briefly goes over that. It doesn't go into the concept of green men, but it explains their significance and the fact that why they were put into those certain Christian temples and things when people were being converted. And you know, they're everywhere. They're in modern artwork. There's much modern artwork. There are water pumps. There are pictures of them. There are, you know, the churches. There are stone carvings from before then. There are, they are really actually extremely prominent in the churches. And usually before then, they were, you know, pots, pans, that sort of thing. But they couldn't, it's green men. They're interesting. And you should do some research on them because they are super interesting. And they're really fun to draw if you try to draw them. They're things where they just sort of sprout out from themselves, which actually sort of, and they are in the way that they are created. You know, they're created either emerging from foliage or part of it. It's like the face, and then out from it come these, you know, the leaves. You probably know exactly what I'm talking about. You've probably seen these and you didn't even know that's what they were. That's what they are. And they're also, like, you could probably count as well, like, if you see people in their yards. I know they don't actively do this to create the image of Green Man, but when they have, like, at my house, for example, they have eyes that they stick in the trees, like, they're like these little stone eyes with these little spigots up, spikes up the back, and you sort of, like, on the tree, and it looks like there's a face on the tree, that sort of thing. Kind of an image of a Green Man. And that's pretty much essentially what I wanted to talk about. I wanted to talk about Green Men. So, this was Radar LaCroix. You can subscribe if you so desire. You can leave a comment if that's what you're into. And you should visit my like page on Facebook. And you should also go to my Tumblr account. Nah, you know what? My Tumblr account's not that awesome right now. It's just got all this little... Ignore my Tumblr account right now, but know where it is, just in case I do something interesting, because that's where I post things that, you know, more about how I'm feeling, because I don't just want to sit here and be like, ugh, my life is so boring. I don't want to do this, like, you don't want to hear about this. But that's where I go to do that sort of stuff. So if you're interested in other people's drama, you could be interested in my drama, and you can go there and you can read about it. I don't have anything up really recent, but you can look, read stuff a while ago. Like, if I have negative encounters, sometimes I'll gripe and moan on there, because I don't want to be on here. On here, you get a lot of people who actually, there's not as much, like, it's not as easy for people to give responses, so I guess I feel safer. I don't act like I'm hiding, like, my opinion, but on here, it's not that important. It's just, if you care, that's where it is. It's all there. So, do what you will with that information. I will see you guys later. I'll try to find more interesting things to talk about. If you know anything about Green Men, if you know where anything interesting, if you find any interesting little tidbits, leave them in the comments or on my page thingy. I do have one somewhere. It's hidden in the dark depths of YouTube. I almost call it Facebook. In the dark depths of Facebook, which there are. You can find them. They're there. Okay, bye. I'm going to stop talking.